Hello, and welcome to this demonstration of using the Red Hat Advanced Cluster Security Cloud Service with Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service Clusters. I'm Chris Porter. I'm a Senior Principal Solution Architect with Red Hat. Today, we'll be giving you a brief introduction to the ACS Cloud Service. We'll be talking about an overview of the ACS Cloud Service installation process. Then we'll walk you through creating an instance of the ACS control plane called Central in the Cloud Service. Then we'll be demonstrating how to install the secured cluster services on an AWS EKS cluster using Helm. Once it's installed, we'll look at some common post-installation tasks, including troubleshooting, and then we'll talk about next steps with ACS. ACS is the security software firm Red Hat that provides cloud-native and Kubernetes-native security. We take a shift left and Kubernetes-focused approach to common security use cases like vulnerability management, network isolation, compliance, risk profiling, and runtime threat detection and incident response. The Red Hat Advanced Cluster Security Cloud Service brings the same capabilities that you may know from ACS into a managed model that reduces some of the operational burden on your teams. Like other Red Hat services in the cloud, it allows you to deploy quickly, get the value of the product immediately, reduce the complexity in your management stack, and allows you to support both on-prem and cloud workloads now and in the future for that hybrid cloud flexibility. Let's talk a little bit about the installation overview. In deploying ACS, we have both a control plane called Central and the secured cluster services. In this case, the Central control plane is going to be running on cloud, Red Hat Cloud, through console.redhat.com, and we're going to provision it there. Once that instance is provisioned, we're going to log into our custom Central deployment, and we're going to create the set of secrets that are required to deploy on EKS. This is called an init bundle. We need this for every cluster that we're going to deploy to. Then we'll use Helm, supply Helm with the init bundle, and that will allow us to deploy the secured cluster services on our EKS cluster. Once Helm is complete, we'll just verify that the installation is running incorrect, and we'll get started using ACS. To get started with the ACS cloud service, you'll need a couple of things. You'll need to be able to navigate to console.redhat.com and have an appropriate set of Red Hat credentials to log in. Once you log in, you'll navigate from the services menu to the security submenu, and then choose advanced cluster security where we'll get started. Let's take a look at that process. Okay, let's take a look at how to provision an ACS control plane instance on the hybrid cloud console. I'm logged in here to console.redhat.com using my Red Hat credentials. I'm going to choose the services menu and go to security and then to advanced cluster security, which will bring me right to the getting started page. When I click get started, I'm going to be given some initial instructions here. We're going to create that instance, wait about 10 minutes, and then we're going to access the central interface to begin the next stage of the installation. When I click create instance here, I'm brought to the list of existing instances if there are any. If not, this will be blank. And I can go ahead and create an ACS instance just by giving it a name. And in my case, I'm choosing to use AWS billing to consume the services here, but there are other models available. Instead of clicking create instance, I'm actually going to use an instance that I configured earlier, and we're going to dive right in. This is the details of My Central. My Central has a specific URL. Take note on the right, the instance details. You will need some of these data points later on when we go to install. In particular, you're going to need the Central API endpoint that we can supply to our Helm chart. And I'll need the Central instance URL here to be able to log in. There's a button that also allows me to go ahead and log into that ACS console. Because the central control plane is tied into Red Hat single sign-on, I can log right in. And since I'm already logged right in, the authentication process will let me have access to this. Now, the ACS interface, very similar to the self-managed interface. On the left-hand side menu, you'll see all the different security capabilities, but these will all be blank until we get a cluster connected. So to start doing that, we start with the clusters page. There are a couple of different options, including UI-driven approaches for creating new clusters and configuration. But we're going to use the most common approach to automating this on EKS, which is to use a Helm chart. To get started, there's an important requirement for deploying on EKS or any cluster. We need to create what's called a cluster init bundle. This is a set of secrets that allows us to access the central services through the EKS cluster that we're deploying on. Without these secrets, the clusters can't authenticate, and the central control plane won't honor the request to join the environment. So it's a security precaution. Once we generate those, we can download them in a couple different formats. Obviously today we're working with Helm, and so we're gonna download that Helm file. You can also download these as a plain Kubernetes secrets file. Because these are secrets, you should store these safely in a secrets manager, not someplace public, and certainly not available to others in the environment here. So once I download these Helm value files, we'll have what we need to go back and take a look at the process for installing on EKS, and demonstrate that to you. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about what's required to install the ACS secured cluster services on EKS. First, of course, you'll need an EKS cluster, and this cluster has to have sufficient resources available to run those ACS components. These components are fairly lightweight, they're stateless, so they don't require any type of persistent storage, but there are some resource requirements, and those are documented on the ACS documentation site. You need the ACS init bundle that we created in the demonstration. We have that. This is an init bundle file that we're going to supply as part of the Helm arguments. Lastly, we do need to provide the cluster that we're installing in the credentials that it needs, a pull secret, to be able to use the Red Hat registry. You can do this with your personal credentials for redhat.com, but the best practice here is to use a service account. The service account can be created, again, through your Red Hat account at the URL that's shown here. Those credentials will be passed, again, to the Helm chart as we go to deploy on EKS. Let's take a look at what that looks like. All right, so here I am in the command line getting prepared to install the ACS secured cluster services to my EKS cluster. First of all, I verified that I have the EKS cluster. I've got connectivity using kubeconfig. I'm going to go ahead and add the repo. In this case, the OpenShift site has the charts for RHACS. I've already had that added here, of course. And then it's always a good idea to update those once you have it to get the latest version of that. In order to deploy, I simply need to provide information to the Helm chart about the ACS control plane destination, the image pull secrets that I need to get the container images, as well as that init bundle that gives the secrets to authenticate to the control plane. I'm going to do that here with a single Helm command. Let's take a look at what this is doing. First of all, we're choosing the namespace StackRHACS. For a variety of reasons, I recommend that you use this exact namespace to deploy. And we're asking Helm to go ahead and create the namespace. We're calling the deployed package here, the StackRHACS secured cluster services, and we're using the chart from the RHACS repo. Now we're going to supply the values file. This values file is something that we'll look at in a moment. This is going to tell the cluster where to connect to the ACS control plane. So rather than supply it as arguments using the set command to Helm, we're actually bundling those into a YAML file. We're also providing that init bundle generated by the cluster by the central control plane instance that we saw earlier. And then lastly, I'm supplying the username and password for the image pull secrets. This is something we recommend using a service account that you can create through your redhat.com account. Once I run this command, I'm going to get some warnings about my Kubernetes configuration file, but Helm is now contacting the cluster, creating the namespace, deploying the instances, and within a few minutes, we'll have our software up and running. And there we go. The deployment here created a namespace. We can go ahead and take a look at the namespace and go and see the pods being created. We're going to basically wait for all of those to get up and running and then go back to the control plane to verify that they're connected. Before we do that, let's take a look at what that Helm values chart contains. Okay, as part of that installation, I supplied a couple of different files. One of those was the cluster init bundle that we generated from the central interface and downloaded and used as is. Another one was the values YAML file, which has configuration for the ACS secured cluster. Now, the list of options available here is pretty extensive. They're documented on the ACS documentation site. There are two required items listed here in bold. So the central endpoint comes from the instance details page that I showed you earlier in the ACS cloud service details page for my central instance. This must be pointed to the right place because that init bundle is only going to work with the central instance that created that init bundle. So this one has to be correct. The other one is to provide a unique cluster name. Every cluster that I connect to a single instance of ACS Central needs to have a unique name. And ACS Central will use that for identifying the cluster in reports, for scoping policies, et cetera. The other items here are all optional. I've got some settings here for admission control and collector. Again, there are a lot more options available, and there are their list of those in the ACS documentation. The other thing that I supplied that I didn't show you the contents of was the image pull secrets. You can either supply these to Helm directly using the --  set command on argument on each of the Helm installation commands, or as I did, you could bundle these into a YAML file, and it looks like this. We're just simply supplying the username and password for the image pull secrets. The Kubernetes cluster, in this case our EKS cluster, needs those to be able to pull the container images for the Red Hat Advanced Cluster Security software from the Red Hat registry. And so this will be required. Now I've logged back into the ACS Central interface, and we can see quite a change here. Under the clusters page, instead of installation instructions, we see our healthy cluster, all the components here up and running, and you'll see that the system has begun to gather data. We can see quite a change on the dashboard here. We're going to see the list of images and deployments, and this tells us that we have a healthy installation here. There's a couple of things specifically you can look at. First, we'd expect to see in the risk page a list of all the running deployments. In my environment, I really just have the ACS components running, so I don't see much else. Here in the vulnerability management, we should see a list of the nodes from the cluster, and we should see a list of the images that the deployments are using. And these are being scanned by ACS for vulnerabilities. If you have other workloads, you'll expect to see those workloads. As ACS is starting up here, it's going to go through that process of identifying all the workloads and beginning that scan process. The results may take a little while before you see them in the UI. On tools like the network graph, where we're looking at capabilities in real time here with information like live connections from pod to pod, you should see lines being drawn here. You should see results in these flows. ACS is busy building a baseline of behavior for every one of these that it's observed. So again, the results will take a while to finalize, but the fact that the data is being populated here tells me that we have a functioning installation of ACS Cloud Service. Let's take a look at what we should do next. Okay, what happens if your installation didn't go that well? How did you even find out, and what do you do to resolve that? Well, it's generally down to a set of Kubernetes troubleshooting steps, like any other application that has a failure in deployment. First of all, we want to verify that all the pods are running. That's the first indicator that a problem is going wrong, that the pods will not be in a running state. If any of those pods are not running, the first thing you should look at is the pod called sensor. Okay, the sensor is the critical portion of the ACS secured cluster services. If the sensor is not running, all of the other pods in your environment will crash. So there's no point in troubleshooting something like collector or admission control until you know that the sensor is working first. Here, you'll need to look at the logs for sensor to see if it's crashing and have an error message to tell us why it's crashing. Or if the sensor is not running at all, if the pod hasn't been created, or it's not able to pull the image, you'll see that if you describe the pod. So again, these are basic, you know, Kubernetes troubleshooting steps for any application out there. What happens? What do I see most of the time? Well, we forget one of the steps that we talked about earlier. If you don't have the pull secrets in the cluster, you know, EKS will not be able to pull those container images from the Red Hat registry where the ACS images are going to be supplied from. You have to have those credentials in the cluster. They're not available. They're not going to be available automatically by default. You might have the incorrect central API endpoint. This is pretty common. If you don't supply a central API endpoint, like we saw in the Helm values chart, then sensor will default to a local endpoint. It'll be looking for a central endpoint within its own cluster. And of course, that won't exist here because our central is in Red Hat Cloud. So you have to get that correct. Missing the init bundle is surprisingly common, right? You do have to have the init bundle. You can reuse the init bundle for multiple clusters, but you do have to supply a valid init bundle to the Helm chart, and it'll warn you if you don't have one that's correct. But if you have the wrong one, if you have one that you've, you know, been deleted from the central configuration, for example, that also won't work. So now that you've got ACS Cloud Service successfully deployed, your secured cluster has checked in, you're starting to see security results on screen for all your workloads, there's a couple of next steps that I'd recommend. There's a lot you could do with ACS, but some pretty common next step configuration tasks, including creating a registry integration for your registries. This allows the ACS vulnerability scanner to retrieve image contents and perform a vulnerability scan against them. So if you have an ECR registry that you're using with your EKS clusters, you should create a configuration to allow the ACS components to talk to that. You should integrate with your single sign-on service. We can support technologies like SAML or OpenID Connect here to allow multiple users to log in. There's a lot of documentation on this. There is role-based access control and access scopes to allow users to get in and perform their duties and see their workloads in there. You should also look at downloading the RHACS command line tool. This is available to download through the ACS user interface, the central interface. It's also available from other Red Hat sources as well as through the API. This is the tool that we use for administering certain capabilities in ACS, but more importantly, it's also the tool that is used for integrating security scanning into your CI/CD pipeline. Lastly, you want to let others know about the security results that we're finding. And you can do that through human-readable destinations like email or Slack, security event management tools like Splunk, and many others, including standards using generic webhooks or the syslog protocol. Obviously, there's a lot more you can do with it. Look forward to seeing you on the next video. Thank you.